Hello and welcome to Walk the Talk. I am Shekhar Gupta and I am here with a story of revival, rebuilding and literally rebirth for this wonderful, it's a bit of a cliched expression, the iconic hotel in Bombay, the Oberoi and Vicky Oberoi, the father of the Oberoi and the son of the Oberoi. So welcome to Walk the Talk.
Thank you.
It's a great feeling. This is a hotel that was in global media just a year and a half ago in very unfortunate circumstances.
Well, this hotel was unfortunately completely destroyed.
This was the battlefield, the lobby.
This was the battlefield. They put bombs. There was a bomb there. A lot of grenades. They broke everything. Quite obvious what they wanted to do. They wanted to kill as many people and do as much damage as possible.
And where were you when you first heard this and what came to your mind?
Well, I was living in the hotel that day.
Right.
But I'd gone to North Bombay for a function.
Right.
And while I was there, I was told that there was an attack. First they thought it was a gang war. So then half an hour later they said it's a terrorist attack.
Right.
So I didn't know what to make of it, obviously, but I didn't have enough information. When I came here and saw what they'd done 2 days later, it was a shock. I was practically in tears. I didn't know how long it would take to restore the hotel or rebuild it, actually. The hotel has been completely rebuilt. Everything is new except the structure. Even the windows are new.
As the rooms are much bigger, we've combined, looks like 3 into 2 or...
Yeah, we've done a lot of for the rooms, we've done quite a bit.
And everything done to Vicky Oberoi standards.
Well,
because you said, the last time we had a conversation, you said you tell your people to try and achieve 99% perfection.
Well, perfection is not easy, and 99.5 if possible.
Oh,
I must give credit to our people. They work very hard to get it to this standard. Eventually, what matters is the customers. Will they like it? I hope they do.
But Vicky, Oberoi's have seen history because Oberoi's have been around for a long time. We saw the partition. So you've seen disasters. Mm. You left your properties behind and came to India. Just tell us a bit more about your thoughts of when this happened. Did you think that hoteliering, hospitality industry will now change forever?
Well, when this incident happened, at first I thought we'd have to completely rebuild the hotel, because when you saw it on the electronic media, there was lots of fire, and they repeated the fire many times. So I thought we'd lost both the hotels. Of course, I was shocked, but I was traumatized. I didn't know what to think, actually, in the initial 2 or 3 days. I watched it on television from hotel in North Bombay. And it was...
In frustration.
Yes.
Because the needs of business travel or luxury travel and the needs of security are contradictory to each other.
That is true.
So does it change the business of travel forever now?
No, I think, for instance, people used to be irritated when they were frisked at the airports.
Right.
I remember when people said it's unnecessary. Insofar as hotels are concerned, I think, or any building is concerned, now people want security. They want to be secure. And they don't find it irritating, except for a few people who always grumble. But by and large, people want to feel more secure.
Tubar.com.